Okay. All right. I hope you guys have your cameras on. I'm always going to say that because I'm staring at you and I'm looking at you and I want to know that you're with me and that you're not just working your business while you're on the phone. I mean, on Zoom, because you guys need to take the time to take the training seriously for yourself and your business. Okay. Doesn't matter what you look like. I threw this beanie on because, you know, I was having a weird hair day. So, all right. We ready to get started? Happy month end. How is everybody doing? Today is day 26. And tonight I want to talk to you guys about one thing. Okay. And please engage with me in the chat because I'm going to look. Hi, buddy. How to not focus on the goal. Okay. And if you already have set goals, I'm going to ask you guys to forget them. Just hear me out. Okay. All right. Any runners on this call? Like you like to go for a run and that's like your thing? Anybody? If you do, let me know. I want to talk about, what do you guys think when people who decide they want to run a marathon, do they do 26 miles on their first run? Right? If you were to run a marathon, your goal would be the finish line, right? We all have an end goal. I know I would immediately think, okay, I can't run 2 miles without stopping. How could I run 26 miles? But who cares? Right now, you aren't focused on 26 miles, 26.2, right? Because you don't have to get there. You only have to care about today. If you run a little further every day, you know, I actually really enjoyed it when Brittany was sharing her journey when she was running further and further. I was so impressed. She ran in the rain. She ran when she didn't want to show up. So think about where you are today compared to where you were when you first started. You've already improved and improvement feels great, right? That's how you guys build confidence. So that's what I mean by not focusing on your end goal. It's not what's important right now. What's important is your process. And I get it, okay? It's really hard to overcome challenges and setbacks when you don't care enough, or worse, when what you care most about is what people think, right? So many people sincerely care about their careers or their health or their families or the environment, politics, or a social cause, yet still give up long before how they manage to achieve a meaningful goal, right? How many people have quit this instead of focusing on the day-to-day habits? How many people have quit on you? The main problem with setting a huge goal, guys, it lies much less with caring and much more in two simple words, here and there, okay? The distance from here, where you start in this business, to there, where you someday want to be, is too great, especially at the beginning. So more often than not, when people start new businesses like this, they want the instant result. And when they don't get to it, they feel defeated. For instance, if your goal is to lose 40 pounds and this week you manage to lose 1 pound, how defeating is that? The distance from here to there is too great. Are you guys with me? If your goal is to save $1 million for retirement and this month you manage to save only $100, we're feeling defeated again. The distance from here to there is too great. If your goal is to go back to school and change careers, and if you manage to complete only one class towards a degree, you're defeated again. The distance from here to there is too great. So that's why I'm saying don't only keep your goal in mind. It can be very discouraging, okay? Thinking about goals is like thinking about winning the lottery, okay? You get to dream big. Imagine yourself living a totally different life, right? And dreams are very important. They make us human. We dare to set nearly impossible goals. Yet everything is worthless about that dream without a process to help us achieve them, right? A dream, once was born, quickly dies without a process to support it. So what's the difference between a goal and a process? I'm gonna give you guys three examples, okay? Say you're a manager. Your goal is to develop your employees. Your process is how you identify areas for improvement, creating implementation plans, following through like on trainings and coaching, feedback, right? Similar to leading an organization here, your process is what you do to make your goal happen. If you're a teacher, Your goal is to help your students reach their potential. What's your process? It's how you craft your lectures, create materials, find ways to motivate students. Again, your process is what you do to make your goal happen. I feel like when we get into this business, we are so obsessed with the idea of where we want to be. And I think that's really what gets in so many people's ways. And I honestly am saying this tonight on this call tonight is because I feel that. I see that. I've been in this business for 4 years. And I honestly think that is one of the biggest problems that I'm realizing more and more and more. I'm like, let's simplify that. Let's not get in our heads. Let's focus. Let's change that focus. The focus isn't SED right now. It's not right now, right? If you're a parent, your goal is to raise healthy, happy kids. Your process is how you build your children's self-confidence and self-esteem, nurture their dreams. And again, your process is what you do to make your goal happen. I hope this is making sense to you guys, because this is like, honestly, I relate to this so much when I think about when I started. So think of this. I actually didn't know this. I just read about this. Take Arnold Schwarzenegger before he became a movie star. Okay. Then he became the governor of California. Did you guys know he was a 6-time Mr. Olympia, which, by the way, I didn't even know what that was, but it's the highest achievement in bodybuilding. Okay. As a teenager, he decided he wanted to win the Mr. Olympia contest, but on a daily basis, he cared only about reps. In his mind, each repetition of an exercise took him one step closer to becoming Mr. Olympia. Okay. At the gym, he wasn't focused on winning the contest. He cared only about doing the reps, about doing the work, about doing what was necessary to get him to his goal. Okay. I actually shared this with some of you already, but when I think about my first year, it's crazy. Running my business, I didn't think about where I was going. I was too caught up in the process. You don't say you're going to run a marathon and stare at the finish line, right? You run, you walk, and you know every step is getting you one step closer to your goal. I'm sure when he wanted to be an Olympian, Mr. Olympia, he set that goal, then he forgot that goal and focused on the reps and the reps and the reps, okay? Because at the end of the day, everybody has goals, guys. People who actually achieve their goals create routines. They build systems. They consistently take the steps that in time will ensure they reach their ultimate goal. Okay. When you guys focus on the process with anything you do, okay, we don't wish, we don't hope, we just stick to the plan consistently. We forget the goal and focus solely on the process. You're going to hear me say this repeatedly on this call, but say you aren't in good shape. So your process calls for you to run 1 mile on that first day. While today you can't run a marathon, you can run 1 mile, right? Are you guys with me? I hope you guys are with me. Because guess what? Running that mile today is all you need to accomplish. You automatically feel good about yourself, okay? You did exactly what you set out to do, and that motivates you to run again tomorrow. Do you see how we can get defeated if we set these, if we focus on the goal and not the process and what you're doing every single day? So because when you compare that to with where you started, you've already improved, and improvement feels awesome too, okay? And one day you guys are going to wake up and realize you can run 5 miles and then 10 and then 20, because each day you compared yourself with what you needed to achieve that day instead of with what you needed to achieve someday. It's hard. We're hard on ourselves, okay? And you know what else? Forgetting your goal unleashes the power of feedback and motivation. This is some facts. Here's two essential truths that I would say. One, none of us receive enough positive feedback. Every time I give a negative feedback, I'll make sure that I add a positive in it. I really, really try to do that. Number two, each of us are our own worst critique. Okay. So for me, I set the goal and then I forget the goal. Why? Because if you guys don't, you will never be able to give yourself positive feedback when you constantly compare yourself with your end goal. That's why you're harder on yourself. I want to hit MDC. I can't think of where I'm going to be then. I just have to do exactly what I know I need to do. I need to get my focus straight. Sometimes we lose our focus. That's fine. But I'm telling you guys, don't focus on the goal. Okay. Because you'll always be your worst critique, because by definition, you will never measure up to what you're comparing yourself to. Why do we want to torture ourselves? Right. I really, really try to only focus on things that I can control and what I can do every day. So, all right, you're probably thinking, well, what's my process, right? In the last 4 years through the process, I discovered my process, okay? It's not like something that I knew right away, but here's what I did every day. One, I started to talk about it, about the opportunity, and I started posting about it. No excuses. The internet never sleeps. You need to start making mistakes regardless of how perfect it is or not. And coming from me, some of you know, I was all about the perfect, you know, I need to make sure the branding and all this, like I just gotta, that's how I started because of my background. So no, you need to get going. You need to start building that reputation online and in person right away. Two, you're building relationships. I make it a habit to connect with people who engage with my stories and posts, or people I want to catch up with to rekindle relationships. That's all I've done in the last 4 years. Even if it was just a thoughtful comment, my goal is to always make a genuine connection. Forget network marketing. That is my goal every day. Okay. Number three, build my network. I make new friends everywhere I go. Now, I'm going to get into a different topic here, but on our flight today, the flight attendant was super freaking nice, like so nice to the point. I just had to tell her, you're one of the nicest like flight attendants person, you know, I've met in a long time. Like, thank you so much, you know? But then when she came back over, I asked if she works as full time because I want to connect with her. Guys, your servers at restaurants, your Uber driver, Uber Eats, everyone, you should be connecting. You should be building that network, not thinking I'm going to sign someone, thinking I'm building my network. Okay. Speaking of building your network, here's a tip for you guys. When you go on your work trips, this is also something that we just experienced. We called for a golf cart on our way to dinner and we ended up sharing with these two girls, and it's on our last night. Okay. Instant icebreaker that you can do is like, oh my God, oh, where are you guys from? As soon as she said LA, I was like, oh my God, give me your number right now. Then they asked us what we're doing in DR. And we said, well, we're here for a work trip. And right away they knew who we were and what my Nate was. So I made a joke and I asked, how many people asked for your number? Guys, she said, I don't know, some guy did. He was creepy, but he wasn't with my Nate. My mouth, my jaw could have dropped on the ground, but I had to like, you know, just play it cool. But no one asked for their number. They were so sweet and cool. She DM'd me right away saying she wants to talk about them on Nate and connect on the opportunity when we're both back in LA. How can we not go on these trips and also connect with people around us? We look like we're running the town when we take over a hotel. So how can we not when we go to Vegas? Guys, when you're qualifying for Vegas this month, remember that when you go there, you're not just there on a work trip. You're literally there to build your network, okay? Now, I do want you guys to remember, we can't think with the here and there mindset, because we can't expect every person we meet off the bat they're going to want to work this business, but we're building our network. 4 years I've been doing that, and I've been doing it the most ever, I would say, in the last year, maybe because we came out of COVID and I'm like, oh, I just want to be around everyone. But seriously, this is so important. How about this? I talk about how I want to be recruiting more because, you know, listen, you lose your focus in this business at times and you got to check yourself back in. Anyone else say that though? I know I need to be recruiting more. I know I need to be posting more. I know I need to be getting VIPs. I know this, I know. But if you respect the process, you know it's all going to come around. What am I going to do? Quit? Bitch about it every day? Be impatient? Right? Believe it or not, there is a process for building great relationships. And since our business is a people business, I'm going to give you guys tips on building great relationships that matter most to me. Okay. One of them is, how about how can I say this? You know, what's a good way? One of the biggest mistakes people often make in network marketing, I believe, is we try too hard. We forget who we are. Before the business, you could talk to anyone at the supermarket, but now it's like, how can I approach them? Why are we losing who we are? I get we're all different. There's no one script. Some of us are more shy than others. Okay. Some of us doubt we're likable. The answer often lies in what likable people don't do. You don't try too hard. people like that are likable already know what they know. They want to know what other people know. They ask questions. I want you guys to ask more questions. Don't just look for an outcome when you're having conversations. Ask for details. You know, where are you from? Oh, why are you guys? Oh my God, what do you guys do for a living? Wow, that's amazing. Normal things that you would do. They care about what other people think, and they show it by listening. Listen to what people are saying. That makes the people that you meet feel important. Okay, that's one of my biggest tips. Another thing that we do in this business, we blame. This is potentials or, you know, in the business. This person was going to sign up, but now my girl basically quit already. She's this. Friends make mistakes. Employees don't meet expectations. Vendors don't deliver on time. It's so easy to blame other people for our problems. But why are we not to blame? Maybe we didn't provide enough information on our potential call or training. Maybe we didn't build enough of a buffer. Maybe we asked for too much too soon. You know why I'm saying this? Because if you guys take responsibility when something doesn't go the way you like, instead of blaming others, it is so much more empowering for you to just be aware of the situation. It's because when you guys focus on doing things smarter, like, you know, next time you're just going to be that much better. Just say, okay, maybe I could have done this. I'm not saying blame yourself, but I'm saying just be more aware and take responsibility. Don't blame other people, right? You're just going to keep getting better. That's another thing. And as long as another thing is we try so hard to impress people when we're building our network. Why? When we're engaging with people, remember that people don't like you for the things you have. They like you. Okay. Don't preach it. Be the person who has accomplished very cool things, but also, you know, be the person that manages to make other people feel like they're the ones who have accomplished very cool things, right? Try it. If you guys want to make new friends or to make better friends, don't focus on your end goal. Focus on the following the process of what I just shared with you. You'll meet more people and have conversations that have more substance than superficial. You'll give more people a chance to share who they really are, which gives you the chance to decide whether they are someone you want to play a bigger part in your life. And then the other thing I want to say is this is something I do a lot. Evaluate recent results. Perfect example. Yesterday, my recent story and reel, I had a call to action on exactly how they can get to my Work With Me application. I was honestly shocked, guys, to see how many people took it. I've never had it that many. I've never had that many people take it. And I've been in the business for 4 years, so I'm telling you that right now. And I'm going to tell you what I discovered, okay? I love creative writing, but that's become a part of my brand. It's not always how I attract people, okay? So evaluating how this worked better in my favor. One, on my story, I took our day on the boat with the team by showing how much fun we're having. But number two, I added verbiage sharing about what we do, okay? Then I wrapped it up with a call to action. That's number three. Call to action really does matter, okay? And then number four, I happened to want to post something the next day, so it tied in with my story, and I made sure to include the same call to action in my caption for my reel. People need to see it multiple times. People need to like be able to relate. They related that we're having fun. They saw that we're on a trip. They know that, you know, what we do. I explained that on the story. Now they see my story on my post. It's just how it works. We want to see what people respond to. We want to see what they care about, right? I looked at it. I'm like, who's engaging? The views, the shares. And what I learned is creating content for your brand. Let me just tell you guys this right now. So if you think you're working your business by creating content, you're not. Creating content for your business has little to do with what pleasing yourself and everything to do with pleasing an audience. And the only way to know what can work is to know the audience. You need to get to know your audience, okay? And when you're building your brand, don't obsess over building your brand. My brand was built in the last 4 years. If you saw me when I first started, I was like, oh. I was so insecure, guys, about telling people that I was in network marketing. Now I shout it and I want people to challenge me and say it's a pyramid scheme. I want people to challenge me and say that, you know, they have all the excuses because, hey, I can relate, but I also have an answer for you. I'm here to educate you. Okay. And I know it sounds simple when I say it like this, but I know that in the moment it might not feel that way, but I'm going to give you another list of tangibles. Okay. One, posting frequently allowed me, this is what posting frequently does. Okay. It allowed me to improve my skills more quickly, increase my chances of how I present the business opportunity because I made mistakes or the products, along with my creative writing and growing my brand. Okay. I like to build a library of posts for new potentials to someday discover. Like, not everyone's going to come. Like, that's why you have to be consistent, right? Number two, building connections provided me an ever-expanding list of great content sources. So I was experimenting frequently with creative writing, which allowed me to quickly learn to craft better captions and call to actions. And eventually I developed my own style, which sometimes people get so upset, like, you know, oh, this person copied or this person. Guys, I encourage you to constantly adapt, and that's okay if people are copying or not. We're all doing the same thing. You're going to figure out your own voice as you go through. Be okay with that, okay? So the more I posted and connected and experimented, the more insights I could evaluate and the better I could understand what people responded to, which led to more and more people reading my posts, right? So I can say in the moment, from a day-to-day point of view, nothing will look like it has changed. Okay. So say you guys listen to this call and you actually put into action and focus on your process every single day. I want you to know, don't you dare have expectations a month from now. It might look like nothing is changing, but you have to follow the same process because it's going to change your business if you stop obsessing over the title. Okay. What will change is your end result, and to some extent you, if you focus on the process. It's going to help you develop the skills and the strategies, and just as important, the confidence and the required to reach your big goal. Okay. So as I'm wrapping this up, I want to know who's ready to forget their goal with me tonight. Okay. I know it's the end of the month and you may think, oh, I'm so far from my goal, but you're closer than you were when you first started. Now, as long as you're not stopping till that clock hits midnight, I know you're all in. Okay. So I want you to run the mile. I want you to run another one tomorrow. To reach a goal, guys, you just don't need to focus on the goal. You need to focus on the process. And one day you guys are going to all look up and realize that here has gotten a lot closer to there than you ever imagined was possible. Okay. I love you guys. It's the end of the month. I want you guys to kill it. Share people's content if you weren't on that trip, and make it damn known to yourself that you are going to make it on the next trip. Don't say it's going to be Vegas. Don't say it's going to be this one. Just focus on the process because you are going to make it. Okay. I love you guys. Happy end of month. Bye.